Hello Abaqus user, welcome to Abaqus Acumen for quick and sound learning. Today's session is again one more exciting session where we are going to do a very simple problem, how you can handle a rotating structure. And a rotating structure is one of the key transmission element within the mechanical engineering. You have several rotating elements, like you have gear, turbines, compressor blades and everything. So we take a similar structure like that, just a representative structure, the structure which is rotating, and then from simulation point you have to do several analysis and simulation on the rotating structure. Is like you have aircraft turbine blade rotating and hit by bird, or you have gear in contacts and then rotating gears, and then there are several things. Is a structure is rotating, and then you want to know how much is a stress generation due to rotation. So mr omega square, so how much is the radial force generated and how the stresses is generated. So you have you have wind turbine and everything. So we are going to do a representative structure for the rotating, and the learning out of that is you'll understand how you can rotate the structure, what typical boundary condition you can use, what typical kinematic constraint you have to use, and then other things. Other major learning is how you can this radial pattern generate within the abacus. So right now you see a rotational velocity of a structure which is rotating, and then we can also quickly check the stress pattern. So how much is a stress generated at the root and how it is generated. So it's a steel structure made up of 3 millimeter thickness, so typical steel property, and 3 millimeter thickness. So we'll try to generate this. So let's go to drawing board. What we are going to learn. So as mentioned, today's topic is mainly how to handle a rotating structure. And rotating structure is very key mechanical transmission element within mechanical engineering. We are going to have a representative structure. So this is like a radius 100 millimeter, and length of blade we are taken a 300 millimeter, and we'll have put a reference point in the center, and that reference point will constrain all degree of freedom except rotation. Typical steel property will use units. Again, we are going to use SI units, turn, newton, millimeter, second. And the major learning is you'll understand how we can give rotational velocity. Now, rotational velocity we are going to give as a initial velocity. So it's a predefined field. Initial predefined field will apply on the structure. And we'll also quickly learn the right hand rule. We are given a 100 radians per second velocity. Because our units are SI units, so this is hundreds radians per second, and then we are giving axis first point and second point, and we'll use a right hand thumb rule, and that represent the direction of rotational velocity. So direction of rotational velocity is depend on how you define the point 1 and point 2, and angular velocity is given 100 radians per second. And then the other major thing is defining a kinematic coupling. So we'll have one reference point, and then we define a kinematic coupling there. Now this kinematic coupling is mainly because the structure, we are not going to represent the shaft. So instead of shaft we are going to just put a reference point, and about that we are going to rotate it. So how you can use a constraint, mainly a coupling, and then kinematic coupling to get the rotation. Just see how the kinematic coupling looks like. So if you go to interaction, and then you say this is how the kinematic coupling looks like. So you have one point, and then put a structured you put a kinematic coupling, and then that kinematic coupling represent the, you can give rotation to whole body. So let's start doing the problem. So I'll say file new. We're going to have dynamic explicit problem this. So let me first check whether I set a directory. So let me first set the directory for the default directory is a C temp. So suggest you to define a write directory, then we'll have rotating structure. So 3D deformable shell extrusion, and this will put 2500. I'll represent the first point 0, 0, and then I'll first put a structure here. And I'll give this is radius is equal to 100. It is already 100. Then specifically you see this radial pattern, but in case your case it may be a linear pattern. So when you by default is a linear pattern, so if you open right now the CIE, you'll see a linear pattern. So let me first put this 300 millimeter. Let me put the dimension for this. So this is 300. It's a perfect. Now you have linear, you go to add, and then you say radial pattern, and then click on the radial pattern. So once you go to radial pattern, it will say select the entity. So I want to just rotate this, so I selected that, and then default it will be like a 5. So I had taken a 18 blade structure, just a representative model for turbine blades. They have 16-18 blade structure, so you have 18 blade, and then you say it, and then you extrude it by 50 millimeter. So this is how you can quickly create a structure. So the major learning is you'll understand how to do a radial pattern. Now let's put a material data, steel. So it's like a 7.85 e power minus 9, and then we put 2 power 10 e power 0.3 and 0.3 as a Poisson's ratio. We'll have shell, and then we'll put a 3 millimeter thickness, and let's assign this. So you define a structure, you define the metal property, section property, and you assign that to component. Now let's quickly create instance. So you created the instant rotating structure. Now I'll just do one thing. I'll just in the center of the structure, I'll just put one reference point. So I go to tool reference point. I know what it is. 0, 0, 0.25, because we are extruded from the 0 point, structure extruded towards the positive 50. So if I put 25, this will come in my center. So this is my center position. So if I do it, so I got a center position there. So then I'll create we are going to do this in dynamic explicit. Rotating structure you can handle in different way, but we are going to use a dynamic explicit. So I'm just going to run it for like a 100 millisecond just to see how the stress pattern generated and everything. You can generally, you can have very short period the initial rotating structure and hit by some impactor or bird strike, and then see how the stress is generated. That tutorial mostly will do in the next session. Then we'll have interaction, and then before interaction I want this surface. So I'll first preference to do a surface. I'll just create surfaces, and I'll just select So let's select the inner surfaces. You select the first and then put a shift button. So shift, you have to hold the shift button. So for zooming you don't have to put the shift button, but then when you select, put a shift button there. So you're done. Now it will ask, because it's a shell, it will ask inner or outer surface. Inner is outer is brown, inner is purple. So you are going to select the purple, so it create the inner surface. And then we are going to create, this is important, so we are going to put a constraint coupling, and then it will select the reference point, which is I've taken a reference point, and then I'll select the surface by set, and then we'll say master slave kinematic coupling, and then all degree of freedom couple. So this way you generated a kinematic coupling here. Now we'll have the loads and boundary condition. So load is center point you'll constrain in all degree of freedom except rotation. So BC1 you are going to select this point. We have done mistake. We have to select BC1 as initial one, because then if you select inside the time step, then you have to give amplitude. So we select before initial condition, and then you put all translation and X and Y rotation constraint, but no Z rotation. So that way you put a constraint, and then rotational velocity is given by initial condition. So you see here the predefined field manager, you go and create, and then you say predefine whatever you give name if you want velocity initial, and give a velocity. Now you have to first select the region. So whole region is going to have initial velocity, so we selected the whole region. It's a uniform, now it is a translation only. You have to change it to rotation only. We are going to give 100 radians per second, which is already a very high velocity, and then you have to give a first point and second point. So you have to take your right hand and then put your thumb from point 1 coordinate to the two, pointing up towards the coordinate 2, and then you curve your forefinger around that point. That is your rotation. So if I put like 0, 0, 0, and then I say 0, 0, 1, so I am moving from this point towards this. So if I keep my thumb here and then curve my finger around that, so this is my rotational velocity. If I put minus, then it will be like this. So we are given this. So even though it shows straight, but it is going to rotate about this. So that is a representation from Abaqus. Let's measure the structure. I first select whole structured, and then select chord middle axis theorem. I'm going to use all will be S4R explicit S4R. I'm going to select, and then I'm going to mesh with 10 millimeter as element thickness. It's a coarse mesh because I want to quickly done this explicit problem. I don't want the small size element controlling the time step. So we define everything. Now let's create a job rotating structure. Let's do a quickly a data check. So we put for a data check. Data check is always handy. It will give us if there is any pre-processor related issues. If there is no pre-processor related, there is no issue. So everything was fine. So let's submit the run. So I will submit it run, and then we'll quickly look how the file looks like. So So let's put a star command. I generally use a text pad, which is very handy. So you have part definition, you have node and then element, then you have assembly, then you have coupling kinematic constraints, then you have define boundary condition, you given a rotational velocity, and that's all. Let's look how far it has gone. So it gone for something, so let's see the results, how it looks like. So it's rotating, and then it's also upgrading the, so as I mentioned, the right hand rule, it start rotating. So let's check how far it has gone. So we'll just wait for this to finish, and then we'll get back to results discussion, and we'll see how it goes. So job is complete. So it just finished the job. Let's see how the structure look like. So it just rotates, and then I just put the speed down. I just put the speed down. If it is fast, in case you will see like this, and then we'll see couple of things. We'll see how the stress generated at the root. Stresses are going to generate at the root because the axial forces will try to pull this blade outward, and then root will get stresses. That is one thing, and then we'll see if how the rotational velocity looks like. It's a displacement. Let me put field output, let me put a rotational velocity here. So how it looks like, so sometime it tip, the velocity is just move up. So this is what quick way how you can do. Through this methodology you can start handling structure. We'll have some complex video coming up which will have this rotating structure hit by bird or some impactor, and how the structure behave, that we can have in the next session. So this was a quick video on the rotating structure. Hope you like this video. Don't forget to like us and subscribe us, and also we will request you, please share this video with your friends and who are in the need of learning the Abaqus. The whole purpose of Abaqus Acumen is to give a quality Abaqus simulation education at free of cost. Thank you. Bye bye.